Okay, so let us begin. Okay, so here is the sketch. Okay, so this is our coding. We saw the same coding yesterday also. So this is not in Tinkercad. Right now it is in the Arduino D. Okay, so let us start. So first of all, before entering any code, first we have to include the servo motor as our header file. Okay, so here we have included by using the command hash include servo.h. So what it does is it will initialize the servo motor. It will include all the libraries into the program of servo motor. Okay, and then we have named the servo as servo itself. Okay, so we'll be using servo in our command, like you can see here and here also. Okay, and then we have to initialize our pins. Okay, what all digital pins we are going to use in our Arduino. Okay, so this is INT is for the initialization. Okay, so we are going to initialize the integer pin, which is the trigger pin, to our digital pin 5, echo pin to our digital pin 6, servo pin to our digital 7, and then we'll initialize the LED and the distance average and the duration that we are looking for. Okay, and there is an array for the average value also to store the value, I mean the average value also. Okay, so here you can see our program begins from here, from the void setup. Okay, so we have started our interfacing using the 9600 baud rate. Okay, so this is the baud rate at which our USB and our Arduino communicates with each other, and the attached pin, servo pin. Okay, so we have used the servo pin as 7. Okay, so these are all the initialization. Okay, so right here this code is for initializing, and here is our code that we start to iterate. Okay, so what it does is it will the trigger pin. Okay, so we all know that our ultrasonic sensor have 4 pins, like the voltage, the ground, the trigger pin, and the receiver pin. Okay, so I hope you can see my screen, right? Yeah, okay. So we have got the pin mode to trigger pin, which is our output. Okay, so we have got our trigger pin as our output, and we take echo pin as our input. Okay, so what happens is the trigger pin will send an ultrasonic sound. Okay, it will send an ultrasonic sound, and when it hits an obstacle, it will reflect back. It will reflect back, and the echo pin receives it. Okay, the echo pin receives it. Okay, so we know now we know the usage of this trigger pin and this echo pin. Okay, the trigger pin is used as an output to provide ultrasonic sensor, and echo pin is used to receive the signals. Okay, and then at that time, when we switch on our device, the servo write will be 0. That means the servo would not move. It will not move at all. And then after a delay of 100 milliseconds, okay, the delay of 100 millisecond, this servo will detach. Okay, and now here is where our calculation works. In this manuscript is where our coding works. Okay, so what it does is digital write 10 high. Okay, so in digital electronics we have two things. Okay, one is high, another is low. So high means 5 volt and low means 0 volt. Okay, we can also say as 5 as like high as on and low as off. Okay, so in digital write, the trigger pin is low right now. Okay, so after a delay of 100 100 millisecond, like as we plug our Arduino, after 100 millisecond this code will start, and as it reaches digital wire trigger pin low, which says that the trigger pin of the ultrasonic sensor is low, after that the 5 millisecond, okay, after 5 millisecond it will turn on. Okay, so our ultrasonic sound is turned on after 5 millisecond, and then it will be turned on for 15 millisecond. Okay, after 15 millisecond the trigger pin will go off. So how it will work, it will turn off, then it will turn on, and then again it will turn off. So while turning on for 15 millisecond, the echo pin at that time, okay, that you can see the echo pin, which is the input, will listen to the ultrasonic sound if there is any reflection of ultrasonic sound. And that is the duration. Okay, so duration, we know what is the duration. Okay, and the distance is what we have to calculate. So how we will calculate the distance? We have an equation here, just duration by 2 the whole divided by 29.1. okay, so we know the basic equation to find the speed, velocity, time and distance, right? So which is like speed is equal to distance by time. So I know the speed, I know the time. Okay, the time is the duration, the speed that we know, like at what speed the sound wave travels, and by that we can find the distance. After that, finding the distance, then we'll go to our another loop. This is the loop, as this is the average distance. Okay, so what it does is it will calculate the average distance. So in order to avoid the false message to come, it will check for three times. Okay, as it checks for three times, and then it will come to a conclusion that there is an obstacle. Okay, so at first time, when I is equal to 0, at that time we know that I is less than 2. So what will happen? It will measure the distance, and we get an average distance in this array. Okay, it's stored in this array. We know average of I is our array. You can see here, see, long average of I. So here it is 3. Okay, the value of array, the value that it can store are 3 values. Okay, so those 3 values can be stored in this array also. Okay, so average of I, which is equal to our distance. And what is distance? The distance that we calculated using this equation. Okay, so then after a delay of 10 seconds, what will happen? It will go to I++. That means it will increment. So at that time, I will become 1, which is less than 2. Then it will go here. It will again calculate the distance, and then it will go to I++, right rate again. Then I is equal to 2. Okay, so we get 2 less than or equal to 2, which is equal to 2. So what will happen is it will stop their iteration there, and then it will exit out of the loop. Okay, and as it exit out of the loop, we can find the average distance, which is distance is equal to average of first row in our array plus the average of second row in of our array plus the third row of our array. So that's why you can see here average of 0, 1 and 2, because of these three array here we have returned the 3. Okay, so this is the size of the array. Okay, so and the whole divided by 3 will give the average. It's pretty basic. Okay, now now after this it will come to our next line, which is if distance is less than 30 centimeter. Okay, you can always adjust as per your need. Okay, you can change the distance as per your need. If you need only 10, then always you can change it to 10 centimeters. Okay, and then as the distance will be, if the distance is less than 10, then what will happen? It will attach the servo pin. After a delay of 1 millisecond, it will write 0, and then after a delay of 3 seconds, it will write 150. Okay, and this 150 is our PWM signal. The PWM signal varies from 0 to 225. Okay, so here I have to do an angular movement, so that's why I am writing 150. If you are doing 255, then it will rotate a full circle. Then after a delay of 1 second, the servo will detach and it will exit out of the loop. And then it will start from the beginning also, beginning itself, right from here. Okay, so this will continue on. So this is how our coding is for our automatic dispenser. Okay, so now let's move on to our designing part, which is using Fusion 360. Okay, so I hope you can see my screen right here. Okay, I hope you can see my screen, right? Can anyone just mention it? Okay, so here we are in our Fusion 360. Okay, this is your basic first interface that you are going to see when you are in your Fusion 360. Okay, so the first thing that you have to do is to save your file as it is. Okay, this is the best thing that you can do. If you don't want to lose your files, okay, this whole platform is in cloud, so you won't lose any file, but still, to be on a safer side, you can always save the file first as you create a project. Okay, so I'm going to name it as automatic dispenser. Okay, so you can see our name here, automatic dispenser version 0. Okay, so this is our first version of our project. Okay, so now we have to do all the calculations. Okay, so let me just show you one design which I made earlier. Okay, so our design is here. Okay, so this is the design which I just created today itself. Okay, it's not fully ready yet. Okay, there are some constraints missing over here. Okay, so this was my first version. Okay, so you can just see see how I made it in my timeline. Always you can just see how did I build it. So this is the timeline preview. Okay, you can watch how you made your project. So today we are going to make a similar item with our Fusion 360 by taking measurements of the sensors, Arduino, which are quite common and are available offline also. Okay, so let me just hit escape. Okay, so we'll just go to our designing part. Okay, so this is our work plane. Okay, so this is known as our work plane. In our work plane, we have many tools to make our model, to make our 3D model. Okay, so the basic thing is that you always start with a 2D design with your mind, and then you think to make it a 3D design. Okay, so that's the most basic part. It's the most easiest thing that you can do to make a model. Okay, so let me just first make something just quite simple. Okay, so I'm just using some basic tools. Okay, I'm going to create. So first of all, what I have to do is I have to create a sketch. Okay, which is our 2D drawing. So I will select at my create sketch. Then I'll select on which plane you want to draw your 2D diagram. Okay, so your 2D design. Okay, so the 2D model that you have to draw on a plane. Okay, so I can select any plane. Okay, so here I am, right now I'm selecting this plane. Okay, so our plane is open. Now in this plane, you can draw any 2D drawings that you want to. Okay, so let me just build something much simpler. Okay, let it be a pen stand. Okay, so first I'm going to try to make a pen stand. So I'll go create, I'll select the rectangle, 2-point rectangle. Let us use a center rectangle. Okay, so I need it to be a square of 10 centimeter. I'll select 100 millimeters by 100 millimeters. So right now you got a square. I'm going to use the command offset now to make the wall thickness. So I need my wall thickness to be 2 millimeters. Okay. And I'm going to extrude it. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to finish my sketch. Okay. Yeah, someone asked a question that Fusion 360 and Tinkercad offline version available. The Tinkercad isn't offline, it's always an online product. It's a cloud based interface. It's a cloud based software, so you can't have a it works on a browser. Okay, so it's just like a web application that you are doing. So the Tinkercad isn't available in offline as a software, but Fusion 360 is available. You can always work offline and online. I'll just show you here in our job status. If you click in this job status, okay, you can select work online, or you can just switch it off if you want to work offline. Okay, if you don't have any net, then you can work offline also. So the Fusion 360 is cloud operated. Okay, so your files are all in the Autodesk server, so you don't have to worry about saving a project, or you can just do some project at our in your home, and then you can continue to make the project at your school or at your colleges also. So that's the advantage of using a cloud software. Okay, we all know the Google Docs as well. Okay, so that's also cloud based. Okay, so here after this, I'm going to use a command known as extrude. Okay, extrude. You can always click it over here, extrude. Okay, so and then I'm going to select my part, then I'm going to lift it off. So you can see how I made a 3D model from a 2D model. I need it to be around 40 millimeter. Okay, so you got a hollow rectangle shaped 3D model. Okay, so let us make a box out of it. I'll extrude it to around 2 millimeters. Hit enter. Okay, so now you can see you got a 3D model. Right, got a 3D model of the object. So you can see how easily we made a 3D object from a 2D design. Okay, so this same principle we are going to use in order to make our automatic hand dispenser. Okay, so let me just go back. Okay, so now let's just start making a 3D model. Okay, so first of all, in order to make a 3D model of the hand dispenser, I'll just show you the image. I'll just share the image over here. Okay, so here you can see our object, right? So you can see here I have made a body by using the references from all these components, all these electronic components. Okay, so I've used a ultrasonic sensor, I've used a Arduino Nano, and I've used a servo motor. Okay, so first of all, what you have to do, you have to take the measurements of the neck, okay, of the bottleneck of the so liquid dispensers that you have. Okay, so okay, so here I'll be using my soap dispensers dimensions as a reference. Okay, so first of all I have to make a sketch. So for that I'll go to create sketch. Okay, I'll just click on create sketch, and then I'll select the plane at which I want to make. Okay, so first of all I am using a center diameter circle. I need to make a circle, then I am going to measure the distance, and so it's around 30 millimeters. Okay, so we made a circle of 30 millimeter. Now I have to use the offset tool in order to make the diameter. Okay, so it's 2 millimeter. Now I'll select rectangle, center point rectangle over here. I need that to be around 20 by Okay, now I'll trim off the excess. Okay, so you can always trim off the excess drawing that is not necessary. And I'm going to use offset. Okay, so you can see here these lines aren't joined. So what I'll do is I'll make another line and I'll just join them. Okay, so now it is joined. Okay, so now you can see.
Okay, so now you can see how we made a crimp. Okay, we made a neck, and the next thing what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the measurements of the sensor. Okay, so it's a rectangle. So I'm going to start from here. So okay, so here I have used Google as my reference for taking the dimensions. If you have a vernier caliper with you, you can always take the dimensions over there also. Okay, so you can see we got a total width of the sensor to be around 45 and 20, because so it's 45 by 20. So yeah, I'm going to make it as 45, sorry, that is 20, okay, 45, okay. So here I have selected, but the problem with 3D printing is that, okay, it's not a problem, but the tolerance we have to set, okay, for the easier insertion of the object, we always have to use a tolerance value. Okay, so okay, so I'll just make it a bit more larger. It's around 21 millimeter by 46 millimeter. Okay, so it's going to be 21 by 46. Okay, so after that I'll select the offset values. I need it to be around 1.5 millimeter. Yes, okay, I'll just okay, that's enough. Okay, okay, so we have a place to hold our ultrasonic sensor. Now we have to carve out the two holes. Okay, as you can see here, our sensor, our ultrasonic sensor, have two holes over here. So I have to carve out these two holes. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to use a technique so that I'll get a 26 millimeter difference between them. Okay, you can do this in your way also. There is no wrong or right way to do this. Okay, so first what I'll do is I'll just join these diagonals and I'll find the center over here. Okay, so you can see you got a triangle, so that's the center of the whole thing, I mean the whole rectangle. Now what I'm going to do is I'll just measure the distance. Okay, so you can see you need 26 millimeter apart. Okay, you need this point and this point to be 26 millimeter apart. So if you divide the 26 by 2, you'll get a point which is in between these two things, right? And it will be the point where the center of the diagonals also meet. Okay, so I'm going to use that basic knowledge in order to, okay, so I got my center over here. And we know that 26 by 2, which is 13. So I'll put 13 over there and I'll draw another line and make a 13 over there also. See, this that simple. After that, I'll to make a circle. So here the diameter is given. Okay, so here the diameter is given to be 16.5. okay, now how do I know that? Can see the distance between this point and, I mean, it shows the distance between this point and this point. Okay, between these two points, and you can see it's 16.5 right over here, and this point, if you extend it, it will come over here. So it's around 6.5. so I'm going to add a little bit more of tolerance, so I'm going with a 17.5. okay,
I'll select 17.5.
Okay, so you can see we got 17.5 over here, and I'll take another circle. Then I'll click on here, center, and then I'm going to draw another circle also, which is 17.5. And then I'm going to trim off the excess lines that I've drawn for the reference. Okay. So I've trimmed off the lines. Okay. So here we got our two circles. Okay. So next, what I'm going to do is, I'll trim off the excess from here also, here as well. Okay. Okay. So we got our basic diagram with us. Okay. So this is the whole for placing our ultrasonic sensor, and the next thing that we have to place is our Arduino Nano. Okay, so right now I'm going to see the Arduino Nano, the measurements of the Arduino Nano. As you can see, it's you can always measure it, or otherwise you can check online also. You just have to click and type Arduino Nano dimensions. Okay, and you have to click on the images, and here in the images you can always see the dimensions. So in this image also I can see dimensions. You can click any other larger diagrams also. Okay. Okay, so here I am going to take this as my reference. Okay. Okay, so these dimensions are in inches. We had to find something in our millimeter range, in the millimeter scale. Okay, so here is the image that I got. Okay, it's an Arduino Nano. The dimension is in millimeter. Okay, so first of all, we had to take the whole length. Okay, which is around 43.18 millimeter. So with some kind of tolerance we are going like around 4, let's go with 44. Okay, let's give some room for that to sit. So I'm going to select another rectangle, 2-point rectangle, and I'll go straight from here. So we got a maximum width of around, so maximum width isn't given, but we can always find it out. So we got around 15.24. Okay, the diameter 1.8, so it will be like around 17, or let's take an 18 millimeter. So we get 44 by 18, reflecting 44 by 18. Okay, so Here we got our another rectangle. So now let us join these together by using simple lines. I made a line over here. I'm going to start with another line over here. And I'm going to trim off the excess lines like this. Okay. I'm going to add another line over here. Otherwise, you can do one more thing. You can always select offset and then you can select the width that you want. So we have put a 1.5 minus 1.5. Okay. You can join these two lines together. You can trim off the excess. So here I'm going to trim off the excess. Okay. So here we got our basic design right now. Now I'm going to add another offset also. Should be an outer. Let's put an out 0.5 minus 1.5. Okay. Okay, so here we got our basic design with us. Okay, you can see here overlapping lines, so I'm going to just trim it off. We don't need that lines anymore. Okay. So we got our basic design now, right? Now this was our 2D drawing. Now what I am going to do is I am going to make this drawing into a 3D drawing. Okay, so how will I do it? I'll just extrude it. So I'll just measure the height which I need. So I need a height of around 20 millimeter. I'll select 20. And hit enter. You can see we got our 3D design, right? It's just like a magic. Okay, so let me just see my sketches, and right now I'll add base. I'll select this and this area also, and I'll want a thickness to be 1.5 millimeter. Okay, I'll just untick the sketch, and yeah, see, right now you can see. Okay, so after this you can always cross check. If you have any kind of mistake, then you can always go back with your timeline. Okay, like this you can always go and you can edit. See, you can edit the older
drawn files. Okay, so let me just check it by measuring the distance. Okay, so what was our distance? It was around, okay, for the ultrasonic sensor it was around 26. Okay, so the distance between the two concentric circles are 26 millimeter. So let us see how much it is when we design. So I'll go to inspect, I'll click on measure, and then I'll select the two circles, and then I'll, okay, so here you can see in our results, okay, in our results area on the right hand side, you can see it is 26 millimeter. Okay, so we need, as per our dimensions, we need 26, and we got 26 in our fusion also. So which means that our designing is accurate. Okay, so after this, what you can do is you can add the parts also if you need, like if you need a sensor, you can always find it in Autodesk Fusion 360 gallery. Okay, I'll just show you an example. Just go to, see, you can just always Google it, like Autodesk Fusion gallery, and search for servo motor. Okay, so you can see standard RC servo, or you can go and click SG90 servo if you need. Okay, and see, here you can see our model. See, this is our 3D model. You can use the 3D option also. Okay, so here you can always play around and look from any dimensions you want to. Okay, so this is our servo motor. Okay. Okay, so I'll just show you how you can import any kind of 3D objects which are pre-made by different creators around the world. Okay, so you can click to your data panel right here. Okay, I have just clicked my data panel right here, and here you can see I have imported this ultrasonic sensor and the servo motor also. Okay, so let me just make a stand also for the motor, so for the servo motor. Okay, so first of all, let me just go and check where can I find my, okay, okay, so here you can see SG90 servo motor, right? So I'll just drag and drop it. It's so simple. I just drag it and drop it over here. Because these are different folders, there will be some constraints. Okay, there are chances of having an error message over here. Okay, so we got an error message. It says design inserted from another project will not be linked. Components from selected design will be copied to the design. So I'll click on proceed. We are just using the servo motor for our reference only. Okay, so now you can just place it wherever you want. Okay, so right now I'm just placing it over here for the time being. Okay, and then let me go to our original folder where we were making this, where we have saved our design. Okay, and then I'm going to select our Arduino Nano, and I'm going to just drag and drop it over here. Okay, so we got our Arduino Nano also over here. Okay, so the Arduino Nano which I am going to be use will not have any standoff legs like this. Okay, these legs aren't present, so I'll just delete it from the design. You can always look after it. Okay, so it's in the bottom face. So you can see pin row 192. See, and in my Arduino, I don't have the pins which I use for flashing the memory and all. I mean the firmware. These pins are also not there. So I'll just delete that also. So it's in the top face and the pin end. Okay. So this is how my Arduino is going to look like. Okay, so let me click home. Let us place this Arduino into our design. So I'm going to click move. I'll select components. The component that I need to move, I'll rotate it to around 180 degree. I'll hit OK. And then I'll move this. Why I'm placing it right now is because I need to take the measurement in order to put the servo motor over there. So that's why. So I'll select the components. So I'm going to rotate it around 90 degree. We have to place it over here. That's why. Okay, so here you can see our design. See, there is a crossover in our design. So which means we have to redesign these things. Why? Because these are not fitting perfectly. So there is a bit of a mistake in our design calculation. So I'm going to extend it. Let me just see the width, if that is correct or not. Let's correct the width also. So right now I'm using this move tool. Not to move. Okay, so the width is almost perfect, I think. Yeah, okay, so the width is almost perfect. So yeah, okay, so I think we have taken the correct measurements. Okay, there is nothing wrong with our measurements. So okay, so one thing I want to do is I just want to rotate it so that the USB part comes to the back side. I'm going to rotate it 180 degree. Then I will just insert it over here. Okay, so now we got our. And the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to make a window in order to add the programming cable over here. So what I'll do is I'll just go and select a rectangle. I'll capture my position. I'll select rectangle. Then I'll select this plane and I'll draw a rectangle over here. Okay, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to extrude it. Okay, so in order to work fast, you can always use you can always use the I mean, you can always use the shortcuts. Okay, there are many shortcuts in Fusion 360. Okay, so here you can see our cable is also out. Okay, so this is our design. See, basic design. And right now I have to place my motor on top of it. So for that, I'm going to draw on top of this motor. I'm going to select a rectangle and I'm going to make a rectangle also over here. Okay, now I'm going to extrude it. To around minus 1.5. Okay, so you can always slide your Arduino Nano into this easily. Okay, you don't need to break anything. You can always insert it easily because of the size. Okay, I'm not having any pinouts for the Arduino. I've already deleted it. In the Arduino which I have with me also don't have all those things. That's why I've deleted it. Okay, and right now I'm going to place my servo motor on top of it. So I'll just click over here. I'll turn it in 90 degree first of all. Okay, so I've turned it in 90 degree. I'll move the positioning. Let me look from the front. Okay, I'll move it on top. Okay, so it's almost centered right now. Okay. I'm going to click OK. Okay, so here is our motor also placed. I'm just going to change the angle to 90 degree. So this will be our position. And At the time, if someone puts the hand beneath it, it will rotate to this much degree and it will come back to its original position. Okay. So this was our basic design, and you can always use text also in Fusion 360. I'll go to create sketch. I'll select my plane. Capture position. Okay. I can select the text. Okay, you can name it whatever you want to. So I'm just going to add a name as basic dispenser. Okay, so it's a written dispenser. I made it a little bit bolder. I can move it. Okay, I'm going to make it a little more bold by using Arial Black. Okay. So yeah, let's make it a little more bigger. Oh, that's too big. Okay, so I'm going to edit it to around 8. Okay, so we have our name also. Now I will engrave this name. For that I'll use the extrude from here, and then I'll select my dispenser and I'll just put it inside for like 0.5 millimeter. Okay, I'll hit enter. Oh, sorry, came outside. Fresh sketch, I use extrude. It'll be selected and I'll select dispenser only. I'll select minus 0.5. Okay, so right now you can see the dispenser is engraved in it. Okay, you can also import the ultrasonic sensor. But I am not using that right now because I have already taken the measurements correctly for the ultrasonic sensor. As we have seen, we have used the design. Okay, so here is our design ready. Now you can modify it. You can always add fillets at the edges. Okay, so here in the edges, you can always add fillets like this. See, I'm going with 2 millimeter. So, and also you can add fillet over here. So what fillet does? It will add strength and aesthetic beauty to your project. You can add fillet over here also, 2 millimeter. Add fillet here also. split here, split around 2 millimeter. Okay, so you can see the edges are smooth. Like we can also make our top section also smooth. So I'm going with 1 millimeter. Okay. In bottom also, I'll add a fillet to about 1 millimeter. Okay, so now you can see this is our design ready. Okay. Now you can use the render. You can always render. If you want to change the appearance, you can always click on A, or you can, what you can do is you can go to modify. Okay, and then click on appearance in order to change the colors. So here I am going to modify, and then I'll click on appearance A. Okay, and then I'll select plastic and the color which I want it to be. So let's make it opaque one. I'll use let's use a white yellow color. So for the bodies and components, I'm going to color it full with yellow. Yes, so now you can see it's fully in yellow color. Okay, so and the servo motor is translucent blue. So I'll use this translucent blue over here. Then I'll use white over here. Okay. Okay, so our basic design is all ready, and we can always crimp it. Okay, one more thing that you can add is a hole over here. So let me select this plane, and here you can add a hole of 4 millimeter, so that you can always screw it tight. Okay. Okay, so this is our model. Okay, now you can 3D print this model, you can assemble everything, you can do the electronics which I showed you, and then your hand dispenser is ready. So in tomorrow's session, what we are going to do is we'll do the session for our, let's say, for our assembly part. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to show you how to slice our object. Okay. So in Fusion 360 in manufacture itself, you can go to design in the manufacture session. What you can do is you can always slice your files, and you can generate G codes. We need G codes for our 3D printing. Okay. So if you want to know more about 3D printing, in the YouTube link which I provided you yesterday, there is a channel. Okay. In that channel, you can go to the playlist, and you can find a playlist named as World of 3D Printing. Here, there I have explained many things about the 3D printing, the current scenario, the current 3D printing techniques, and how to use different kinds of software and all. So you have to check that out also. Okay, so right now we are in our manufacturer workspace. Okay, and I'm going to generate a G code. So what I'll do is I'll select additive, because it's an additive manufacturing, and then I am going to go to setup and add a new setup. Okay, so first of all, I am going to select my machine. Okay, I am going to select my Creality Ender 3. Okay, this is my machine. Okay, so I've selected my machine. So I'll select my print settings also. I'm going to use 1.75, 2 millimeter. Okay, select okay, and the operation type is additive. Okay, now I clicked on okay. Okay, so our model is ready to print right now. Okay, so okay, so now I can move it. I can move my objects. So I want it to be like this. Okay. I'll go to actions and generate the G code. And you can always simulate also. Okay. You can simulate our toolpath. Let me just show you a basic example. Okay, so here you can see build plate, and you can see layer by layer formation. So this is how 3D printing will work. Okay, so this is our design. Okay, the rest is this it is the support material. Okay, so if we are moving it to our bed plate, then we don't require any support material for this. Let me just show you another software also, which is known as Cura. Okay, so I'll go back to my design. Okay, I'll go to home and I'll click on the bodies and I'll just make a click on save as STL, which is stereolithography. It is a kind of file format. Okay, and then I'm going to click OK. So I'm going to save it as, let's make this. So, okay, now I'll save my file. So right now, can find it over here. Yes, I have already opened the Cura, the Cura software. This is the interface that you are going to see. Okay, so right now it's not responding. Let us just wait. Okay, so it's same as using Fusion 360 in the manufacturer. Okay, so what it is doing is it's a slicing software, so it will slice our model. Okay, so here it is ready right now. Okay, so this is our build plate for our 3D printer. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll import my design. Let's make a 3D printer and I'll just drag and drop it over here. Okay, so you can see your model over here. I'll just rotate it. Just rotate it around 90 degree. Okay, I'll just slice it. So while slicing, now you have a G code which you can save to a file, or you can just connect an USB and transfer it over there. And now you can also see a live preview also of 3D printing in the software itself, which is simulation, as I have just shown you in the Fusion 360 also. Okay, so here in the right hand side, you can see the layers. There are 132 layers total. You can see how it will be printing. Okay, you can also see the toolpath moving. Okay, by clicking this play button, you can see how the toolpath will move while 3D printing. See. Okay, so that's it for today's class. Let us meet tomorrow. Tomorrow will be our assembly day. So I'll be 3D printing it and I'll be assembling it all together as a video. I'll just share it with you. Okay. So tomorrow is our assembly part. So thank you for joining today. I hope you all have a good day ahead. Okay, so it's time for a Q&A session. So can you just tell me how was the class? Was I audible or anything like that? If you have any kind of doubts. Okay, so I'm going to just finish my today's session. Thank you for joining. Let us meet tomorrow.